गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर बैक टू आर वीडियो. वी वर डिस्कसिंग इंडियन इकोनॉमी ऑन द ईव ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड लो लेवल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट, लो रेट ऑफ ग्रोथ इन एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर, स्लो ग्रोथ ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर एंड फॉरन ट्रेड. इन यस्टरडेज जूम क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फॉरन ट्रेड एंड वी विल बी रिवाइजिंग इट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. नाउ टूडे आई एम सेंडिंग यू द वीडियो ऑफ डेमोग्राफिक कंडीशन. द मीनिंग ऑफ डेमोग्राफी इज पॉपुलेशन. So we are evaluating the condition of population in terms of quantity and quality. All of you must be aware that population is census is conducted after every 10 years. It is an attempt to find out the population growth of the country. So the one marker question which can be asked here with to you is, when was the first official census conducted? So please note down, first point is very important for one mark MCQ. It was conducted in 1881 and is conducted after every 10 years. Now we are discussing the features of demographic condition at the time of independence. How was our population at that time? The first thing is, the pattern observed was very uneven. That means at times the population growth was high, then the second year it was very low, and so on. However, for our estimation purpose, we take 1921 as a dividing year. It is also called year of great divide. And what it does is, if we study the pattern, it divides population into two parts. One is before 1921 and second is after 1921. Pre-1921, population growth was highly erratic and uneven. That means it was slowing down, it was rising, year to year variation was observed. But after 1921, high population growth was observed. That means population growth had been steadily rising after 1921. So again, a one marker question, what is the importance of the year 1921? It divides the population into two parts. One is erratic, the other is steady rise. Then now coming to the qualitative indicators of population, let us evaluate in terms of the quality of population. We are saying that the literacy rate was very low. Less than 16% literacy rate was there at that time. And female literacy was even lesser. It was 7%. And next thing is the health facility. Now all of you understand the significance of health in determining the quality of population. So all of us know that at the time of independence, it was lacking. Public health facilities were not there. It was inadequate. We had high mortality rate and infant mortality rate. So mortality rate talks about the adult population. Infant mortality, as you must be aware, talks about the number of deaths below 1 year, or at times it is 5 year also. Is it clear? So the mortality rate was 218 per thousand, which was considered very, very high. And the life expectancy was around 44 years as compared to 66 now. So these indicators from here to here, they talks about the quality of population, and these indicators, they are talking about the pattern of population and the quantity. So if a question comes on, elaborate the demographic condition at the time of independence, your answer should include both the parts, the quantity as well as the quality, and all these points are to be included. One markers can be expected on the data. What was the life expectancy at that time? Infant mortality at that time? What is the importance of the year 1921, and so on. So remaining part we shall discuss tomorrow or on Monday. See you then. Have a great day. Thank you.